Hey guys, welcome to our cardio and core HIIT session. We have a lot of control exercises today, a lot of deep core work. We're actually gonna start on our back. Our times are gonna be 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. We're gonna do it real time. We're gonna be working together. So we're all gonna start together with a crunch. So 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. A lot of core mobility control work today. And let me make it a little louder so you can hear the beep. And we begin with a crunch. So on your back, let's do this. Exhale, lift the shoulder blades up. Inhale, lower back down. We lift the shoulder blades as well as activating the pelvic floor. Just waking that core up, keeping the head heavy on your hands. Exhale, lift, inhale, drop. 8 seconds. And then we release it. And in just 6 seconds, we're gonna go into a bridge and we're gonna alternate our legs, marching them out. So we exhale, lift it up. One knee comes up and then switch. Working on the stabilization of your pelvis, keeping your core on. Again, your pelvic floor should be activated here. Let's keep it going for another 8 seconds. One more, and then we're gonna release it. Both legs are gonna come forward straight. You're gonna point your toes, and I want you to already now, we've got 3 more seconds here, I want you to already now press your back into the floor. Inhale, reach your hands up. Exhale, slowly come up, touch your toes, slowly come back down. And then from here, we're gonna go into bicycles. This is gonna be the last move before we really get into more movement, more control, more cardio. So bicycles with pointed feet. Alternating, focusing on the stabilization of the pelvis, of the lumbar spine, reaching your foot forward as though you really wanna touch the wall in front of you. Ten more seconds. And then we release it. And now we're gonna flip over. I'm gonna use my handles for a high plank. And we're going to alternate legs into, from a pyramid into a lunge. And we're gonna do this twice today. So just take your time, figure it out. We're gonna do it soon again. So the right leg goes up. We bring it forward between the hands. We come up to balance. Okay, bring it back, switch. Left goes up. Left comes between the hands, come up to balance. Bring it back. Right goes up, right between the hands, up to balance, bring it back. Come on down, get onto your knees. You're gonna be standing on your knees. If you need to squat instead of the up, up, down, down on your legs, squat instead. Or it's up, up, down, down, and switch. If possible, we pick up the pace a little bit. And I want you to really think about the movement being generated from the heel. So you dig the heel into the floor to come up to standing. And then from here, we're gonna get into, again, into the leg goes up in the pyramid, comes forward, and bring it up to balance. Right leg up, between the hands, balance. Again, here, there's a lot of emphasis on the heel. So the left leg comes forward, I dig the heel into the floor, come up to balance. Bring it back, right leg up, between the hands, dig the heel up to balance. bring it down. Left goes up, between the heel, up to balance. Between the hands, I meant to say. Next up, we're gonna go into a sumo squat. And when you go down, the heels are on the floor. When you come up, the heels are off the floor. So I want you to go as far down as possible, press the thighs out. We come up, lift the heels, bring it down. One more. And now, either you're gonna pulse in a sumo squat, so you're gonna stay in the sumo and just pulse it up and down, or we're gonna do little bounces and we're gonna jump it up. Now, if the full sit-up is too much, maybe for your back today, you're just gonna crunch to the right. Don't worry about sitting all the way up, okay? I want you in control of movements around your back. All the way down, please. All the way down. Let me switch. Last exercise on our back, hands at the base of the skull, legs can be here, here, or here, and we pulse the shoulder blades up. We go down past our shoulder blades, then pulse it up. The positioning of your legs is very important. If you're feeling any back pain, you must modify either to this position or to the feet on the floor, okay? There has to be no or little to no movement in the pelvis, keeping your back pressed into the floor. 3, 2, oh. Okay, flip it over. Get onto your hands or your handles. Now, we're gonna turn it around. So we're on our left hand, turn it around. Bring the right leg back, tap it forward, switch it, and now bring the toes on the floor. Okay, and just gently hover the hands over the floor and lift the left leg. Then, same side, we bring it around, same side. We tap it back, tap it forward. A slight tap, left leg, and down. Let's do the other side. I'm gonna stay in the plank. Okay, open it up, leg taps back. Tap forward, toes on the floor. Then we try to hover. We're keeping the left heel off the floor. We bring it down. We open to a side plank. We tap it back. We tap it forward. We drive the left toes forward. We try to stay on the toes and lift the back leg, hovering with the hands over the floor. Bring it back. Okay, same thing. We're gonna do one side only over to the left, opening up to the right. over and over, maybe we can pick up our pace. So we open up, tap, toes, switch it, come forward, very light with the hands. Bring it back, back, open, tap back, bring it forward on the toes, lift. Bring it back, side plank, tap, toes, and again, bring it back, side plank, let me complete it, bring it forward, I'm gonna hold the plank. All right, open up, tap, bring it forward onto your toes, hover, bring it back, tap it on the toes, hover, bring it back, on the toes, come on up to standing. We're gonna squat on our toes, heels off the floor, knees are looking forward, thighs are parallel to each other, all the way up and down, staying on the toes. If it's too much, what you can do is what we did in the sumo, where we brought the heels down, then we lifted them up, okay? So you can do that kind of game with the heels going down and up. A lot of balance here. Zip up the pelvic floor, zip up the lower fibers of the abdominals. Now, we're either gonna go for little pulsing squat jumps, or we're gonna do the same move that we just did, okay? So either repeat that, or it's this. Let's pick up the pace. And then we've got one more segment in the same format. Two. On our back. All right, guys. Steady bicycle. Crunch only to the right. Now, if it's painful for your back to hover with the left leg over the floor, don't. Just press it down. Just let it hang out on the floor, resting. Okay, because that little lift is actually what intensifies the exercise. Really turn, really get the chest to look at the right. Switch. Same thing. Together, the knees are apart. The closer the heels are to your butt, the harder you're gonna work. So we bring our hands overhead, we come up and we try to touch our toes. Neutral spine. So you want to avoid picking up the butt, and you want to make sure you're keeping your hands pressed into the floor and constantly coming out of those shoulder blades. Oh my God. All right, from here, we're gonna go into slow motion mountain climbers. Slow motion because actually the emphasis would be on holding the core plank, switch, hold, switch, hold, switch. Really crunching the abs each time. Make it about the abs, not about the cardio here. Make it about pushing the hands into the floor, coming out of those shoulder blades. 3 seconds. All right, once again, we're gonna do that exaggerated tap out. Let's go. All right, really trying to keep the hips low. Really pushing the hands into the floor. This is deep oblique and core work. Oh, Lord. Okay, guys, on our knees, either you're gonna squat, okay, you can come up to standing, or you're gonna do the up, up, down, down again together with me. Left and right. Oh, wow. That last one, man. And stay standing, please. Okay, guys, we're gonna do the sumo again. This time your heels are off the floor the whole time. Press the knees out. We're going up and down, keeping the heels off the floor. I have a sneeze that's just kind of hanging out there. Getting back into either repeating that, but making it smaller, or doing the pulsing sumo jump that we did before. So keep doing what you're doing. If you're doing the other exercise, I want you to pulse it, okay? But if you're jumping, you're still pulsing it, but the heels land on the floor. Oh. 3, 2. Okay, guys, here comes the major control and balance work. We're on our left leg, right leg goes back. If you can, it stays in the air. If it's too much, it goes down onto the floor while you maintain your back long. Now, see if you can lift the heel just a little bit, the left heel. So if you're doing it on the left toe, on with the right toes down, it looks like this. You can also hold on to a wall. Rest for a moment. We're doing the other side, same thing. You're just kind of testing out your balance. This week, there's gonna be a lot of balance work. This is kind of like our opening shot, boom, of the week. Also, note the difference between sides. Wow. Keep your core on, your pelvic floor lifted. Okay, this is your final exercise for today. Now, You can go in for crunches just like we did in the very beginning. Or if possible, you're going to go into the boat with me with your legs together. So remember, you can just go for crunches, but if possible, you're gonna go into the boat. Now you can do what I just did, which is I brought my lumbar spine off the floor to make it a tiny bit harder. If you want, you can also try to bring your arms up. If it's too much, you know, go do what you need to do for today. And then we're gonna go all the way up to release into a butterfly position. That's it, guys. So a lot of core control and balance. Like I said, today was kind of like the get ready, set, go for this week, where we really are gonna get into a lot of deep core control and balance work. We're gonna bring the elbows towards our belly. The head comes forward, and then I want you to bring the elbows now out, and the head goes down. Let's then lean on the right arm. The legs are going to be together. Pull the knee way back. Open up the chest. And switch. Way back. And release. Straighten both legs, flex them strongly, get the booty back a little bit. Reach your hands up overhead, inhale, exhale, coming up and over. And release it. Guys, I'm gonna see you tomorrow. I'm actually really excited about this week. I really, really am. Like, we're gonna be doing all kinds of fun moves that I've been working on for you guys and for me, for us guys. And please tell your friends about Bodyholic if you have not yet. Invite them to join you for these challenges. Every day is a challenge on its own, whether it's flexibility, core, balance, please tell them. And if you are a neighbor and you live in Tel Aviv, I hope you're gonna join me for the workshop on July 16th, the Mindfulness Strength Flow. If you're watching this in 2022, then July 16th. And I'll see you guys soon. Thank you so much for joining me.